my curse. I only forget myself.
Who have more than others and choose to hoard their possessions.
So, evil does have a name.
can't think. Are you a doctor? Did the United States Space Administration send you? They must have issued you a stim pack, right? Oh, thank you. So, you're real after all, huh? That's a relief.
Oh, I can feel it working, but just so tired. Not sure if I can stand quite yet.
My name is Commander Sophia Daguerre. I'm an astronaut with the USSA.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Yes, I'm the pilot of the Deep Sleep mission, launched in 2070. Maybe you recognize me from the news. Well, minus the head wound. My ship crashed nearby. I could barely walk, but somehow I made it here. I must have hit my head in the crash. Hard to remember. Thanks for your concern. I'm still woozy, but much better. Thanks. I said that already, didn't I? Oh, that's a relief. Thank you. I figured the military would have arrived for the crashed ship. It's been a while, though. I still haven't heard from my crew either. Oh, God. I can't believe this is happening. I need to find my crew. Contact the USSA. Oh, get some first aid. One thing at a time, though. Where am I, anyway? The remnants of Appalachia? What do you mean? I remember... Almost... Damn it. What do you mean, remnants?
We launched the Deep Sleep mission in 2070, and I entered the hibernation pod very shortly after we achieved orbit. Why do you ask? Oh. Oh no. Well, that is not the kind of question I was hoping to hear right now. I was supposed to emerge in 2075, with an optional extension to 2080, if things were going well. The mechanical engineer on the crew, Dr. Bernard, he helped me into the deep sleeper pod. He said, see you in a few years, and we waved at each other.
Are you serious? You can't be serious. Tell me you're just trying to be funny here. Please. But the USSA had contingencies, plans, fail-safes, backup robotic agents. Damn it. This wasn't supposed to happen.
I think I need to focus on just finding my crew. There were three others, and I didn't see anybody or any bodies. So they had to be in the ship, or maybe only my emergency pod crashed. I don't know. Could you go to the crash site and look for the ship's flight recorder? It's not far. Not far at all. I can't can't walk much right now, but you can almost see it from here. Almost. Take a right from the bunker. Cross the river. It's not too deep. Then, follow the mountain. Thank you. I truly appreciate it. My body is still shaking, so I'm gonna just try to stay still and listen to the comms. Just in case.
Thank you. Analyzing sample. Analysis complete. Knowledge base updated.
Moving.
guessing nobody from the Space Administration was up there collecting evidence and looking for survivors. Huh. Oh, that's a relief. Now, we just have to decrypt it to access the data. Our ship's robot would have had a standard-grade USSA encryption key. If it survived the crash, it would be heading back to the nearest military depot. The escape pod's robot is an Assaultron, I think. It's responsible for the encryption key. Last I was able to check its signal, it was returning to a military base or doing diagnostics. It's hard to tell. It's simple, really. Get to the robot and get the encryption key. I can tune its transmitter signal to your external device there. You should be able to track it down.
Warning, do not interfere. This unit is on an emergency assignment. Direct inquiries to Director of the USSA. This unit carries various encryption keys for USSA flight recorders manufactured between 2066 and 2070. Confirmed. Nonsense detected. Alert. Damaging USSA property.
just a bit. Oh, my head.
Nice work.
It's killing
Sensors
me.
Sensors indicate the problem squatters have been removed. Check in with me from time to time. I may have additional assignments for you to carry out.
I had hoped I could reprogram this console here. But it's barely functional. Did you find the encryption key? That's okay. We have to do what we have to do right now. Thanks for getting the key. Though, without a functioning console, it's not doing me a whole heck of a lot of good. It holds data related to our positions, so the rescuers can find all of us. In case something happens on re-entry. A failsafe, really. I don't know if it will work. But I don't know how else to find my crew without this, since our comms are down. I'm not sure it'd be worth it, all the flooding down here. But we might be able to rebuild it, above ground. You wouldn't know of a secure location, would you? Oh, okay. That makes sense. Well, here. I know it's probably not much, but it's all I have. I don't want to slow you down, though. Maybe you should take these schematics. Get that console rebuilt at your camp. I should be able to get there by the time it's built. And, hey, thanks for your help. I bet this was not what you planned to do today, but I'm real glad you found me. Thanks for giving me a place to stay for a bit. Yeah. This place should do just fine. Thanks for setting up the console. I can work with this. This console looks pretty good. A little rusty in places, though. I guess you got these parts from a junkyard, huh? Resourceful. The scanner currently has a model 38X2, which is built for scanning very specific locations. Not bad, but I would like to improve it. The year before I launched, the military was rolling out some scanner upgrades. One of those could give us more speed and detail in our scans. Can you find a scanner upgrade module for this? It would help us find so much more, and much more quickly. The upgrade module should extend the range of the scanner in our console here rather substantially. I can then cross-check some of the USSA data that you gathered from my ship's console, which will help isolate specific useful signals. I don't suppose you can just swing by a tech supply store, hmm? Yeah, I didn't think so. Last I knew, these types of things were common items in military bases and compounds. But my information is admittedly out of date. I'll transfer the coordinates to a local military base, but I can't vouch for its security status. It's hard to detect anything specific right now. Swell. In the meantime, I'll fix up this console a bit. Did you know that it still uses the outdated P-14B configuration for its power chamber? I mean, I know you all survived the end of the world, but using this as is would be like living in squalor and the apocalypse. Listen, I know you've done a lot for me already. Got me out of that sunken bunker and let me stay here. It means a lot. You saw my wreck, didn't you? I don't know how else to prove it to you. You know, it's equally surprising to me that you've survived all of this. It's good that wonders never cease, right? No. I need a TF-85B adapter to improve the visual fidelity of the scanner, but those were being phased out when I launched decades ago. So, now I need to be the one to adapt, or else. Right? Right? Oh well. Anyway, no, I don't really have what I need, but I'm making do. I think I can muddle through with this. It's hard. I don't know what to say. It's more than I ever expected could happen. This wasn't even in the realm of possibilities when I launched. But I could have been worse. I need to remember that. Copy. Over and out. Nice place. I mean, I think it's nice anyway.